Hey everyone, good morning. It's Anahata. How are you? I have a question for you. All of you who aspire to perhaps write a book or contribute in some way through teaching about things that you know will help humanity, will help people thrive and survive. And it's called coaching. It's a huge, you know, $22 billion industry, and many people take their hand at it and they try it out, and they've got a really good heart. You know, I call these people heartpreneurs. They want to share their wisdom with the world. They want to make the world a better place. A lot of them, could be you, become practitioners of some sort of modality, and quickly realize that, you know, even if they worked 40 hours a week, they couldn't service as many people as are in need of their offerings. Or perhaps they feel like they can't reach the people that need them, etc. And so it can be frustrating, but it all comes down to just not understanding the technology and the ways in which you can set up your bliss biz, I call it. And whether or not you are doing this actively or just considering it, you know, there's two things that you need. One, wisdom, and two, desire. Okay, so it starts with desire. Do you have a strong enough why? Because that's going to have to carry you through the tough times as well. Because the reality is 95% fail. That's just the reality. And it has nothing to do with you and your message, or you and your heart, or you and your value, and everything to do with you and if you understand the ways to leverage your message and to get it out there to the people who need it. I call it microdosing, because I think one of the biggest issues that heartpreneurs have is that they are trying to complicate things. Their message, the why, you know, a lot of upstream marketing going on. Why would you need me versus do you have this issue? Well, come listen to me. Anyway, the other thing is, you know, beyond getting the wisdom you need to succeed, you really have to get on the bandwidth, the vibrational frequency of the person that you want to be. Okay, this takes time, this takes energy, this takes focus, this takes daily commitment. And so, you know, any successful person has first visioned themselves before it occurred. It doesn't just happen. If it, you know, you aren't the you that you seek yet. So what steps are you taking to actuate that reality? It has to be a conscious choice. Otherwise, it will just be a dream that you never actually follow through on. So guys, I've been at it for 7 years now. I've been assisting people in activating frequencies that align them with the version of themselves that they desire. And this has come in the form of two things. Both are basically distilling the essence of something and making it digestible by way of codes and by way of microdosing your magic. So this is how it seamlessly transposes from the Anahata Codes modality, which is the law of attraction of energy medicine, and supporting heartpreneurs, because it's the same thing. When I channel the essence of a tree so that people can come in contact with it on a visceral level and an instant level, it's the same as if I talk to a heartpreneur and say, hey, look, this is a simple way that you can microdose your magic and get it to those who need you. Because guys, if I started 7 years ago and didn't have a clue about graphic design, marketing, things like that, if I hadn't spent two decades in that industry, I would have been dead in the water. And so I applaud all of you folks who didn't go to school for that and didn't learn about how to build websites and funnels and all of that. Holy cow, the fact that you're even trying is noble, because you know there are some things you absolutely have to have. Otherwise, it isn't going to happen. It can be so frustrating because you feel that your message deserves to be out there, and it does. and it's just not reaching the people that you thought it would, and it's not you. It's just the approach, and I can support you in microdosing your magic, distilling the essence of what it is you need to share, coming up with unique, creative, simplistic ways to create a process around that. And people love processes. They love easiness. Complexity does not equal value. And of course, the one-to-many approach that we can leverage really is the reason why I can work from where I want, when I want, for whom I want, and for those who love it. So if a bliss biz is something you've been considering, or perhaps you just want to get in touch with some logical steps of change towards alignment with the person that you want to be. Okay, this is actuating your best self as well. It's not just a bliss biz. Your bliss biz is your health. Your bliss biz is your relationships. It's your business. It's what you do on the daily, right? And it adds up to how you feel about yourself, and how you think and feel about yourself adds up to what you attract, what you align with, the circumstances that come to you, and of course your tribe. You know, how you vibe is how your tribe will vibe. And so it's a beautiful thing when you can become consciously aware of simple tools and techniques to get you there. And perhaps you just want to lift the hood off and look inside as a fly on the wall what it really takes to create pivotal workshops and fill your programs. Even if you don't have any, what will it really take? Because the other thing about this is I want to, cut to the chase and not sugarcoat anything, really evaluate from a zoomed out landscape, the full scope and the true path to achieving your goals in this way. Do you have what it takes? You may ask yourself and take a look at the full scope and go, no, I don't. And that's fine, but wouldn't you rather know now? Likewise, if you have all the information and you decide, oh my God, yes, I'm gonna commit to doing this. That's all you need, is a desire to say, yes, I'm going to make this happen. I'm gonna align with that version of myself. I'm going to make it a reality, finally. And that's all you need, is the want. And the rest will fall into place, because you'll be on that bandwidth of not just probability, but faith. Faith in knowing that what you want will come to fruition as you take the actionable steps towards, in a logical way, towards transformation into the person, the bliss biz that you have within your heart. And so what's the point of this? Hey, Lori, how are you? What's the point of this very long you can do it speech? Because you guys, you can do anything you want. You just have to align with it. And in fact, the only reason why you don't have certain things is because you haven't made it a part of your identity yet. I know it seems like a catch-22, but it really is. And you know, if you had what you wanted, you'd have it, but you don't, because it's not you yet. So what do you need to do? You need to transform yourself into the person that you would need to be to accomplish that goal, whatever it is. And so, are you taking the steps to align with the people, places, things? Are you speaking as they would? Are you acting as they would? Are you dressing like the future you? This isn't a dress rehearsal, you know? We're stepping towards it. And I just carpe diem, really, right? If not now, then when? And so if you want to be a fly on the wall and listen to me for an hour, I'm having a Zoom call and I'm gonna disclose everything, the good, the bad, the ugly, the reality of what it takes to own your bliss biz. Now guys, I've been doing this for 7 years. I've worked very, very hard. Okay, there's certain things I wish I knew then that I know now, that I'm just gonna give you the hacks, the shortcuts. Why not? I don't believe in competition. I believe each of you, if you genuinely have a space in your heart to improve the planet, now is the time we need you. And this time of I'm not sure, or I don't know if I'm ready, or I'll do it when, that time is over. We can't afford that anymore. You're either going to do it or you aren't. You're either going to be in or out. And this should help you determine that. This Zoom call that I'm going to have, it's on Thursday. There is no replay. Show up for yourself. It's going to be an hour long. You're going to have the opportunity to ask me any questions you want. I'm going to be fully transparent about the journey I've had so far, the tools and tips I have, the things I would avoid, the things I would absolutely get busy doing. And it doesn't matter how much time you have, guys, you can do it. My Bliss Biz runs on 3 hours a day. That's it. I know, and I'm not saying it like, hey, great for me, I only have to work 3 hours. Because I don't feel like I'm working at all. But, you know, I set my Bliss Biz hours. I'm very efficient. I know exactly what I need to be doing. Inspiration flows through me because I'm aligning continually with the person that I want to be. And of course, that doesn't include self-development. I am obsessed with self-development in all areas of my life. So, you know, I work out at least an hour a day. I eat well. I take care of my body. I take care of my mind. I take care of my soul. I'm in a Zen space, you know, on purpose. I come to the beach, which I chose to move to because I needed to be near the water, right? So even though my Bliss Biz hours are only 3 hours a day, I'm continually walking meditation of alignment with the person, the circumstances, the people, the places, the things, the vibrational components needed to up-level into the most extraordinary version of myself that I can imagine, okay? So it's a 24-hour thing, but you need to have certain basic information to understand if this is for you or not, and that's what I want to help people with. Rather than just dabbling or saying someday, you know, someday I'll do it, someday I'll write that book, someday I'll think about creating that, you know, program to better the world. Now or never, guys, because days turn into months and years, and you look back and you say, wow, I coulda, woulda, shoulda. So what's your why? Do you have a strong enough why? If not, guys, as you work on yourself, things will rise up to the forefront. And your mess and the obstacles you have overcome become your magic, become what you can shine a light on and improve the world with. So you really just need to have a desire to want to work when you want, where you want, for whom you want. And the rest will come into place if you truly decide you want to align with that version of yourself. And you take the necessary steps to educate yourself on what it's going to take, what to do, what not to do, and start using your intuition to align with that path that is already laid out before you. That version of you already exists. That's the pain point. That's, you know, holding yourself apart from your greatness is the reason you feel unsatisfied. And guys, I gotta tell you, I wake up every morning overflowing with gratitude and satisfaction because I know even if something in my world doesn't reflect exactly what I want it to in terms of my goals, I know it's only a matter of time because I'm going for it and I will succeed. And you know, people have often already called me like, wow, everything just seems to work out for you and you're just so blessed. It's a choice. You have to make a conscious choice every day to align with the you that you want to be. And it's an evolution. And it's not hard. You just have to use the laws of the universe. So I want to share everything with you this Thursday, 3:30 Eastern. And if you can't attend live, sorry, you know, you got to show up for yourself. If the time isn't convenient, I'm so sorry. I tried to make a time that wouldn't be too late for, you know, there are people all around the globe tuning in lately. So, you know, making it not too late, not too early, for as many as possible. Anyway, guys, like, share, and the event, there's no registration required. It's just in my Microdose Your Magic group. So go to Microdose Your Magic, the Facebook group. The link is here in the description, and I'll see you in there. And then Thursday, it's going to be illuminating is all I have to say about it. Inspiring, illuminating, and time saving, right? If you think, oh, I just don't have time to attend. Well, this could be the biggest time saver that you do for this year. And I want your success because everyone deserves to see your fullness, and everyone's voice deserves to be heard, and everyone's magic deserves to be consumed and partaken of and digested and celebrated. And you know, people need your magic. They need your medicine. So you know, if not for you, do it for them. But I hope you do it for you as well. You are amazing. I love you all. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you on Thursday. Mwah. Bye for now.